Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to be spending some time on IEC 61000-4-39 testing using the TESTEC NSG4070 C2-110 RF immunity test system along with the corresponding antennas. We're going to begin the video by going over a little bit about the test system and the antennas. Then we'll move to the software, and then finally we'll go ahead and run a calibration. During today's video, we're going to be using the TESTEC NSG4070 C2-110 test system with the TESTEC LAS 6120 and 6100 antenna kits. The NSG4070 C2-110 can be used for this test and has a built-in amplifier meeting the test level requirements. In many situations, however, the NSG4070 C-LFCP is also used. We're going to be using the ICD.control software for today's video, which we'll take a little closer look at later. Throughout the video, we're going to be referencing the data sheets, user manuals, and the magnetic field testing brochure. These are available on the product pages on our website, which I'll put a link for in the description below. Let's go ahead now and let's take a look at the LAS 6120 and the LAS 6100. Here you'll find the LAS 6120 radiating loop antenna kit and sensor. The LAS 6120 kit is designed to generate close proximity magnetic fields for immunity testing in accordance with IEC 61000-4-39. IEC 60601-1-2, as well as MIL standard 461 RS101. The RLA 6120-20 radiating loop antenna, as well as the corresponding accessories, have a frequency range from 25 Hz all the way up to 150 kHz. Let's go ahead now and let's walk through some of the different accessories and components that are included. Starting in the upper left along the top, we have the tripod fixture. Below that, towards the corner, we have the radiation area panel. Next to that, the FSL 6040-51 loop sensor. To the right of that, the CSP 9160A current probe. And then finally, all the way on the right, we have the spacer and the RLA 6120-20 radiating loop antenna. Just above the radiating loop antenna in the upper right hand corner, we also have a few adapters that are used in testing. Now let's go ahead and let's take a look at the LAS 6100. The LAS 6100 radiating loop antenna kit and sensor has a frequency range of 150 kHz. To 30 megahertz, meeting the testing requirements of IEC 61000-4-39 and IEC 60601-1-2. This kit uses the RLA 6100-3 radiating loop, as well as the ANP 4039 adapter to allow for more field strength at 13.56 megahertz, as required by IEC 60601-1-2. Let's go ahead now and let's walk through some of the different components that are included. Starting on the upper left, we have our N to BNC adapter. Next to that, we have the tripod fixture. In the lower left corner, we have the radiation area panel. And then next to that, the ANP 4039 impedance matching network. As we work our way right, we have the FSL 6040-1. And then finally, all the way on the right, we have our loop antenna, the RLA 6100-3, as well as the spacer. Now let's go ahead and let's get the LAS 6120 kit set up and let's take a look. All right, here you'll find the LAS 6120 setup for the test level setting following the instructions on the user manual. Let's go ahead and let's take a look at some of the components briefly. Starting on the front, we have our FSL6040-51 loop sensor attached to the spacer. The spacer is set inside the radiating loop antenna RLA612-20. The loop antenna is secured to the tripod fixture, which can be easily attached to common tripods. We have our amplifier out connection on our 4070 going to our loop antenna, and then we have the output from our loop sensor going to our channel 1 power meter. We also have the current probe around one of the cables going towards the loop antenna, and then the output on that probe connected to channel 2 on the power meter. Now that our setup is complete, let's go ahead and let's take a look at the software. All right, here you're going to find the starting display for the ICD.control software. You can see there's a few options here. What we're interested in today is the radiated magnetic field testing and close proximity, which is going to be the fourth option over here. Now you can see right now, there's the NSG4070 LFCP selected. We're going to hit that drop down and we're going to go to the NSG4070C2-110. Now let's go ahead and let's hit select. All right, here is the starting menu for the ICD.control software. You can see right now, we do have the main display open. We have the open on the left where we have last standard test, last vector test, and then we have our recent standard test where we have IEC 61000-4-39 already showing. But let's go ahead now and let's go to standard test in the upper left corner and let's see what's available there. Okay, so here is our standard selection menu. You can see we navigated through the industrial standards, through basic, to IEC, and then finally all the way to IEC 61000-4-39. So you'll see there's an HF and LF version. And if you click on the information on there, you can see the different frequency ranges that each applies to. So let's go ahead and let's click on IEC 61000-4-39, the low frequency component. All right, here is our test menu for IEC 61000-4-39. You will see we're currently in the test tab. We have our standard listed along the top there, as well as the corresponding frequency range. Below that, we have our step. Next to that, the modulation. And then below the step, we have our dwell time. Just below the dwell time, we have our graph. To the right of that, our test level. And then along the bottom, we have our coupling device, calibration file, and loop current. So prior to running this test, we have to run the calibration. So let's go ahead and click on the calibration tab. All right, so looking at the calibration information here, we have our frequency entered. We have adjusted the step slightly just to allow for a faster calibration for today's video. We kept the default modulation as well as the other criteria in this menu. So now let's go ahead and let's look over here in the bottom right corner. There you'll see the start and then below that a check. Now if you do click that check right there, it's going to verify your setup just like that. And you'll see a pop-up box at the bottom. Settings are correct. Test is ready to start. So now let's go ahead and let's run our calibration. All right, it looks like the calibration was successful. That should complete the video today on IEC 61000-4-39 testing with the TESTEC NSG4070C2-110. We began the video by walking through a little bit about the test system as well as the antenna kits. Then we took a look at the software and we ran a really quick calibration. We hope this video has been useful, and please keep us in mind if you ever need to rent any test equipment for IEC 61000-4-39.